That he didn't specifically say what exactly he was objecting to. I'm not going to apologize for trying to do something while they're doing nothing.
Even if he gets sued.
The suit is a stunt.
He's talking about John Boehner suing him for abuse of executive power. Well, if he doesn't think John Boehner has a case, I'm curious as to how the president would explain that Supreme Court ruling. Audio soundbite 9, Jonathan Turley gets into this. SCOTUS already said he's abusing his power. Listen.
This is becoming something of a serial violation for the president. You know, what the president did here, I can't imagine any competent lawyer would look at it and say, yes, you do have that authority. It was clearly an effort to circumvent. And what's interesting, Sean, is that there's a little paragraph in this long 100-page opinion that has been overlooked. The paragraph from the court says that this clause is not there for branches to work around other branches. It essentially was a veiled reference to this concept of going it alone. The court said there's a clear purpose to this clause. It's not there to be used effectively as a weapon. And I think that's a shot across the bow in a lot of these different areas. Yep.
It was a shot across the bow, absolutely. Oh, there's no mistaking it. No mistaking it. Audio soundbite 8, Charles Krauthammer. If this had been a different party identity, it would have been impeachable. Well, we'll play this when we come back. We're opening up the phone lines and going to the phones when we come back, so stay right where you are.
Show. Talk lines are open now at 866-455-9797. This is The Dana Show.
You can find me again at DanaRadio.com. I'm Twitter at DLash. Dana on the Blaze, 5 Eastern, 4 Central, going daily very soon. I want to go to the phones and get some of your calls in because we still have hate mail to get into. And then I don't know if I'm going to hit this. I have to hit the story today. It's a Friday story. I'll just tell you really quick the headline, and then we're going to go to the phones. The nightmare nanny who came to stay and now won't leave. Families fight to kick out a caregiver who refuses to work and now wants them to stay out of their own house. This took place in California from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Yeah, let that sit and simmer for a little bit. Let's go to the phones and get some of your calls in. We've had so much to talk about today. Jeff, good afternoon to you. Happy Friday, my friend.
Oh, happy Friday to you. You know, as depressing as all this is about Cochran, you win some, you lose some. But come November, the establishment Republicans and the Tea Party have to work together to get control of the Senate away from Harry Reid. I mean, yeah, we won in Virginia. Cantor's gone. We're just going to have to suck it up and go in Mississippi.
I just can't stand the thought of Harry Reid as a Senate Majority Leader, just personally, and because I think of Supreme Court nominations. I think of immigration. I think of so much that needs to be done
Democrats
that we'll not be able to accomplish with him.
The Republicans in two.
They are, absolutely. But you know what? It doesn't help the matters that Haley Barbour and Thad Cochran went right along with it. And so I think, well, my fear in this, Jeff, is that if they have no consequences to pay, it will establish a precedence, and GOP will think, well, we can just impugn people and their characters like this, and it's not going to cost us. That's my fear.
Oh, no, we can hold their feet to the fire once the Republicans take over. The conservatives can hold Cochran and everybody else's feet to the fire until they do sensible things.
Yeah, I want your optimism. I'm just still, the more I hear about this, the more I'm just, I don't know. But I understand. I mean, we can't have Harry Reid is the Senate Majority Leader, but at the same time, and God bless you, Jeff, we can't have people like Haley Barbour and Thad Cochran doing what they're doing. We just can't. I mean, that's just despicable. Rob, good afternoon to you. Happy Friday. Thanks for calling in.
Hey, happy Friday to you.
Yeah.
How are you?
I'm doing quite well. It's Friday. You know, it's Friday's always good. What's happening?
I used to call and kind of give you a hard time because I was pretty liberal when you first started in St. Louis.
Right.
And, I just wanted to tell you that I'm sorry and that you've kind of changed me. And as I get older, it seems like I'm moving more towards the right.
You know, I think that is so incredibly cool and gracious for you to do that and call in and do that. And I appreciate it. And thank you.
And I wanted to talk about a funny story in Washington, Missouri, where I live. They're trying to annex a lot of part around Washington into the city. Well, people in the city had signs that were just too big for their yard, apparently, more than the required 8 square feet.
Right.
So the city is requiring them to take them down for the vote no on annexation.
Oh, isn't that convenient how they're, that's nice. Of course.
Well, they've never had any signs, you know, their signs trying to, you know, be too big or.
Right. exactly. No, I completely get that. And that it frustrates me, the abuse of, because they don't.
Yeah. And all of a sudden
we're going to have a problem with your size of sign.
Too big.
Yeah. You know what? That's a great observation, too. And you know, all politics are local, and local government is just, and it doesn't even matter where you are, be it in St. Louis, be it in Illinois, be it in Texas. It seems that it is a national epidemic, but, and you're
and
right
Washington
on that.
Well, a local paper called the Missourian that, is kind of on their side, you know, so they kind of got their own, little vocal area to voice their opinions and stuff.
Exactly.
And so I'd like to urge people to vote no for annexation.
And that's August 5th. People would want that, Well, I appreciate you calling in, Rob. And you know what? That's very cool of you to do so. And I was right there with you like years ago. So I know,
I called you in and gave you. I called in and gave you a hard time then, probably in, 2007. So.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate it, Rob. Hey, you have a good weekend, my friend.
You too.
Thanks for calling in. All right, take care. That's very cool. And like I said, people who, you know, they come and they begin to consider alternative ways of going about issues and, you know, different means of accomplishing an end. That is like one of the most open-minded things that somebody can do. That's why I always, you know, I've always been, and I know some people that I see kind of, you know, really on both sides that do this. And when people sort of change their politics and go over, everybody wants to put them in some kind of political quarantine, I just think that you encourage it, because I know how it was for me when I don't know if it's so much as you age, Kevin. I think it's as you become more educated and open minded, you realize, because I know I sure did, you know, you start looking at things differently. So I don't know. It's just all very interesting. We have Jennifer on line 5. Jennifer, good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon. Thanks for taking my call. I'm a recovering liberal myself, so I think everyone should be encouraged to open their eyes. I'm calling because I think that I'm hearing a lot of conversation about the Cochran episode, which is just another in the production show of our money and our will and our establishment policies are going to go against you. And I think that we should look at it as a win, because it's only going to infuriate and thereby motivate more people to do the right thing.
That's a great point. The true colors
are showing. I mean, that's just what it is. And
when they've had to go to this point to accomplish that, but 6 years ago, it would not have even come to this. And that's how much I think that, you know, grassroots has grown just in that time, the influence.
I agree. And I mean, I'm grassroots all the way, trying to stop city-county merger between St. Louis City and St. Louis County. So I was interested in his comments about annexation. I just did an interview for another radio show that'll air on Monday. But I mean, grassroots is growing, and these types of episodes will only help spur that growth.
Right. Absolutely. Yep. Yeah, it ends up working against them in the end. They think it's a short-run victory, but in the end, it's really going to come back on them. That's a great point, Jennifer. I appreciate the call in. Thanks so much. Thanks. I want to get Pete here, too. Pete, good afternoon to you. Happy Friday. Thanks for calling in.
Hey, Dana, how you doing?
Excellent, sir.
I'm here in Indianapolis, and my whole take on this thing in Mississippi, you know, the Republican Party has taken, you know, I'm a Tea Party type myself, you know, small government, to heck with the social.